to tonight's episode of Beyond Focus TV. I'm Lydia Patel, and as always, I have a very special guest for you, Kevin Howell, author of All You Could Eat. He'll be with us for the next 30 minutes, so stay with us. You're watching Beyond Focus TV.
Beyond Focus TV allows you to discuss contemporary topics affecting the Caribbean people on both a national and local level. The show features informed guests who offer insight, debate, and evaluate various issues. Beyond Focus TV builds on the station's mission to provide useful information to the Caribbean people in New York and abroad. Beyond Focus TV, where our viewing audience can get educated, informed, and empowered.
Welcome back. You're watching Beyond Focus TV. I'm Lydia Patel. Like I said, I have a very special guest for you, Mr. Kevin Howell, author of All You Could Eat. Welcome to the program.
Thank you. Thanks for having me, Lydia.
Well, it's great to have you here. Of course, we love different people in the community who are doing amazing things, and of course, being an author. Self-published is an interesting task because it's not always easy. We'll kind of get into that in just a little bit, but wanted to get started with, what's your background? How did this all kind of come about for you?
How does it all come along? I guess it started 20 years ago, somewhere around here. I did accounting in high school. Love for the subject. Then I did my degree, first degree in accounting and economics. Then I went to PwC, PricewaterhouseCoopers Jamaica, as an auditor. Then I left, got bored. Seemed to get bored easily. I got bored and I came to grad school. Did an MBA in finance and accounting again. I was trying to stay away from accounting this time, but actually end up doing it.
Sucked you back in.
Right. It's like sucked you back in. And then I went to Ernst & Young, where I did M&A advisory or transaction advisory. Over the last 8 years, I've been running the Anchor Group, a company I formed after I left Broadridge, fintech company out of New Jersey, where I did strategy and business development. And I believe that all the training that I did at ENY and at PwC was really solidified at Broadridge.
Really?
Yeah, it's interesting. I got a chance to see the real world in action. And I know consultants don't want me to say this, but it's one thing when you're assessing people's stuff versus when you're creating your own stuff. And so at ENY and in the consulting environment, we were assessing what was. While in a strategic role, you are basically creating what you want to be, something to be. And so it's a different skill set. And so I was able to get the creation skill set solidified and connecting that with my what things essentially was, or assessing the whole element of it. And so both schools were really important in my journey. Started Anchor in 2009 and got stuck in the world of entrepreneurship, and has done a lot of things over the last 8 years. And I'm here now and I'm loving it. I'm loving just the way how things have evolved. And sometimes it feels like it's gone too slow in terms of you have this big vision and big dreams. And it's not underpinning financial money. It's underpinning impact. And being able to see it growing slowly, like a seed that you plant, and then tomorrow you go, you see a little bud, and then after that you see the stem start growing even bigger, and then the leaves, and I think I'm at leaf stage now.
Okay.
And it's ready. It's getting there where the fruit is essentially popping up. And if I could tantamount All You Can Eat to one of the fruit, yeah. So
think you can make it happen?
Yeah. I mean, I'm excited. So that's
awesome.
Me.
Mm-hmm. That's really great. And, you know, being an entrepreneur, you know, a lot of people, when they finally catch that bug, it's like they don't want to leave it. You know, I've spoken to so many people who are entrepreneurs, and a lot of people have very similar paths. You know, they've worked 10, 15, maybe 20 years for somebody. And now when they have the opportunity, you know, it was always something that lingered in their mind that they wanted to branch out and do their own. And it's about timing. You know, you have to giving up that security of a check every 2 weeks is not easy. So kind of share that with us, you know, initially giving it up and really starting the anchor group, and you make your own decisions, set your own schedule, you're essentially your own boss. How was that for you?
As I said, I got in it not planned. I had in the back of my mind that someday I might be an entrepreneur. Someday I might be an entrepreneur. But I left Broadridge and it wasn't a good fit after a while, and I wasn't getting what I wanted. And so I left and I came over to basically just there, and I started to model a little bit. And I really never liked that because I wasn't comfortable. I wasn't comfortable with being a model. I never liked how people were treated in that environment. Mm-hmm. And I felt I have an MBA. I've worked at the largest accounting firm in the world. I don't need to allow people to...
And you were literally nothing in those people's eyes.
Correct, correct. I mean, you were one of... you were lower than the clothing that you were wearing.
You were the hanger.
Exactly.
And that is it.
Exactly. And I never liked it. But at the same time, while I was pursuing that, I figured I had to pull my skill sets together. What is it that I was good at? What could I sell? And so I started Anchor Business Consultancy. Long before we dubbed it the Anchor Group, it was called Anchor Business Consultancy. And after 6 months in it, it's as if something got birthed in me, and mm-hmm. I just wanted to do it. And then I think some of the challenges were finding who your clients really were.
Right.
I think those are some of the challenges. Who is your client? And it took me a little while to figure that out. But I believe where the adjustment came was I realized it was less about who I was from a skill set perspective, and it was more about what did people need.
Well, that's always interesting because you got to provide a need. Once there's a need, you will always have a demand for it.
Right. So no need, which is essentially a part of demand, because that's also something I learned and it's in the book, where you have people who need your product but don't have the resources to buy your product. So there are times when I would spend 2 hours preparing for a pitch session, then I'll spend 2 hours in the session, then I'll come back and write a proposal for 2 hours. So it's almost 6 hours, and then you send a proposal over to the client or the prospect, as it were, and you don't hear anything from them. And you said to yourself, like, hey, I mean, I don't hear anything from you. And then you started to realize that the issue wasn't the client. The issue was you were trying to provide a level of service to a group that, one, never understood it, two, wasn't able to pay for it, even though they desired it. And one of the big things in the book is about what demand really is. Demand is the desire for and the willingness to pay.
That is amazing. Well, hold that thought. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. You're watching Beyond Focus TV. Stay with us. You're watching Beyond Focus TV. I'm Lydia Patel, sitting here at Kevin Howell. So Kevin, great first segment, really, really engaging. You know, definitely kind of dived in and really gave us some really engaging insights on that, actually.
Right.
So fast forward, you're talking about
demand. Right. So demand is, so you got to understand that as a business owner, you had to find something that people need and were willing to pay for. And that is a process of doing, acting, and quickly adjusting. So you're there, you're engaging the audience or the potential customers, and you're ready to adjust. And one of the things with consulting businesses, which the Anchor Group is you're selling something that is intangible. Like really, really, really intangible. And people will like you and all of that good stuff, and you'll sound good to them, and you'll give them a good pitch. But at the end of the day, they can't touch it until it's completed. So when you go to the store, you buy a bottle of water, you get a bottle of water, and you can, in 2 seconds, you can drink that bottle of water off. When you decide you want a business plan, it's going to take that person a month to create that business plan. And you got to go through a process, which in a lot of times, a lot of businesses have never gone through that process of ideation and coming up with a mission and understanding their target market. And a lot of businesses have never done that. And so what you find happening is you are at a place where in 2011, I asked myself, I was like, you need a product. You need a product. I think that's where the old book started in me, is that you need a product. You need something that you can write once and deliver to many. Deliver to many.
I like that.
Right. And so I came up with the concept of the book in 2011. I mapped it out. One day the title came to me, All You Can Eat. I was like, okay, interesting. It's not finance. But I played with it. And so many people over the journey of the book, I mean, have tried to drive me to change the title.
Mm-hmm.
And what's interesting, one day I was sitting there and I was trying to find a website.
Mm-hmm.
And All You Can Eat was already taken, and a number of, variations were already taken. And I said, how about I use all of the first letters? And I was like, oh my God, All You Can Eat, A-Y-C-E, ace.
Yes.
And I mean, it was exciting because something that came to your
spirit. A little light bulb.
Right. Something that came to your spirit like 5 years ago, the name, and then now you're able to take that name and do so much with it, right? I mean, and we get into all of that. But the long and short is, the journey has not been a smooth journey, but what I come to realize that if you don't have a plan, you're going to fail.
Absolutely.
If you don't have a plan, you're going to fail, because even as I said earlier that you are adjusting as you go, you're not adjusting and creating a new business altogether each time the customers aren't responding the way you want them to respond. What you're doing is you are pivoting around the same center.
Mm-hmm.
So your strategy or your mission is clear. You are a consulting firm that does X. The question is, what can you package or pivot around this center that will essentially connect with the market? And so the book came and started writing it in 2013, put it down for rest.
Mm-hmm.
I got bored. It was like, I got bored. I was chasing everything else.
Writing your book.
No, I got bored of it. But so fast forwarding from 2013, now it's 2017. 4 years later, if I had written the book in 2013 and just finished it, it would not be anything like this book today.
For better or for worse, you think?
For better. For a lot, lot better. The book now is not just academic. It is a lot of application,
mm-hmm.
all right? It's application. And for me, that's what made All You Can Eat extremely amazing, because over the last It's like an autobiography.
Of course.
It's